All right, good morning, guys, or good afternoon, whichever time of day you're watching this one. So, trying to make sure you're good on your warm up. Here's your warm up. I would press pause at this point, keep it on the screen, and then you'll be able to give it your best shot. And then once you do, you'll be able to kind of go from here and see what I'm actually working on. So, you should have pressed pause, and then I'm going to go ahead and take care of these real quick. All right, so to find the equation of the line between these two points, the first thing I have to do is find the slope between those two points. So we've been practicing that for 2 days now. So the first thing I'm gonna do is 9 minus 6, and then on the bottom, -4 minus -2. So I end up with 3/-2 as my slope, because that negative becomes plus. So that's my slope, which is important, but we still have to find the b value. And in order to find the b value, we're going to use our blank equals blank times blank plus b process. So we go ahead and plug in everything that we know. The first thing I'm going to plug in is that slope I just found, -3/2. And then I'm going to choose one of my points. It doesn't matter which one you choose. So I'll just go with the first one. Remember that this is your y and this is your x. So it's super important that you plug those in correctly. When you simplify, something that should be pretty easy, not only do the negatives become positive, but the twos cancel each other out. So I'm simply left with 6 equals +3 plus b, which means b is going to equal +3 because we'll subtract that 3 over. All right, so don't forget you are not done because we actually have to have an equation here. So your equation is y = -3/2, that's your slope, x plus your b value 3. So that's our entire equation. These next two questions are back to the review from unit 0, solving an equation with fractions. So the first thing we should have done was multiplied everybody by 4, multiply by 4, multiply by 4. I'm going to kind of speed through this one. So you have 8/3 + 3x, because those 4s are gone, equals 20. Now I'm going to multiply everybody by 3. So I multiply by 3, multiply by 3, multiply by 3, crosses out 8 + 24x equals, excuse me, not 24x, that's not an 8, that's a 3. 3 times 3, so 9x equals 60, right? So finish it out by subtracting over the 8. We're left with 9x equals 52, because we've subtracted the 8 over, and then we can divide that 52 by 9 and simplify if we can, but nothing goes into both 9 and 52, so that's actually your answer. All right, the last one should be straightforward. I'm not going to bother even doing it. Pretty easy to distribute there, combine like terms, and get on x's on one side or the other. So if none of those made sense, rewatch them, see how it's going, but that was your warm-up. The next video is going to jump into the first part of our lesson.